Hello everybody, this is Kevin, and we're back with another episode of Star Fox 64. Oh yeah, I love this game. I love it so much, we're doing it again. That's right.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, so this is the opening scene that you get when you initially fly into Corneria. I skipped it last time because I was kind of rushing through it, but I decided this time I'd show you because we're going down the easy route, and it's not going to take that much time to, basically go through it because it's easy. So, yeah.
Falco here.
Anyway, regardless, it basically introduces you to the characters, and it gives you a nice close-in view of the R-Wing. It's pretty nice. I remember the first time I saw this, I believe this game came out in 1997, but I got it when I was 8. So, I got it in 1998, so, that means I was 8 years old. Yeah. So anyway, I was looking at this for the first time and I was so amazed. I was like, oh, like mind equals blown at the graphics that I was looking at. I was like, man, this is cutting edge. You know, my 8-year-old mind cannot comprehend it. So, yeah. But anyway, so, you know, it's the same thing as before for the first level. It's pretty simple. The only reason I'm gonna show it is just so you can see what, I don't know, what to do different. I mean, there's not much. But, you know, it's just good. What's the word I'm looking for here? It's for posterity, I guess.
We're entering Corneria City now.
So, yes. Yes, we are, Fox. Yes. Yes, it is, Falco. And, boop, I missed the gold ring because I was going for a silver ring. I don't want to get on my ass. I always know not to go for that silver ring. It's like a trap, but whatever. Anyway, so as you can see, we're pretty much breezing through the stage here. There's nothing, like I said, nothing new. So, I'm definitely utilizing the boost a lot more in the easy route, because in the harder route, there's a lot you can miss if you just kind of boost through it all. But for the easy route, I know it pretty well, so, there's not much you can miss, even if you are just boosting your way through it all. Now, see here, I chose to save Falco because, well, see, if you're going to go through the difficult route, you're going to want to save Falco, okay? If you're going through the easy route, you don't have to, but I like to have Falco with me most of the way, you know? I mean, hey, we've got a connection. He was there all the way through the difficult route, okay? So, Falco, I heart you. No homo. Anyway, so, yeah. And these guys, let's kill them. Yes. Oh, no, I didn't do a barrel roll. I fail. But whatever, it doesn't matter. So, yeah, here's the water skater guys, they're pretty simple, and, okay, whatever, it doesn't matter, we got the bomb, let's go another one, and yeah, anyway, to make sure you don't go in the hard route, you have to make sure you don't go through all of these, okay, or you have to let Falco die, well, not die, but get shot down, basically, taken out, whatever. You know, if you have a personal vendetta against Falco, then that would probably be pretty easy for you. But anyway, yes, as you can tell from Slippy, the enemy is dead ahead. Now, you fight this battle in all ranged mode, which basically, it's the first fight that you do in all ranged mode in the game, if you're going down the easy route. Now, this boss is really easy, but I wanted to challenge myself a little bit because I know how easy he can be and I didn't want to take advantage of it. You can shoot off his legs, and if you do that, you basically immobilize him. You can shoot off his legs and his limbs. You can immobilize him if you do that, and then you can just go right for his back, which is pretty easy. I wanted to get his back without actually killing him.
No!
No! Yeah, and every time he shoots back, he goes, no! So, yeah. That's a pretty weak no, so, hey, Captain Guy, let me show you what a real no is like. Okay, little guy?
No!
Thank you, Darth Vader. Anyway, see, Darth Vader, he's a badass. This first boss, he's not a badass, okay? This first boss is a punk. So, yeah. Slippy, you are such a woman. You know, I remember when I first played through this game, I think I said this before, but I thought Slippy was a girl.
I'm fine.
And
okay over there, Buck?
I totally did not know it was a boy until I, like, got older, and, you know, I looked stuff up and I realized, oh, Slippy's a boy, holy shit. So, yeah. Good news there, everybody. Anyway, so, the second stage of the easy route is the meteor field, asteroid belt, whatever you want to call it. It's pretty straightforward. So, since that only took about 5 minutes to complete the first level, I'm probably going to be combining the two stages for every episode up until Venom.
I won't let you down,
so, yeah. Anyway, this place, you can get a really high kill count here using bombs. And bombs pretty much break the... bombs pretty much break the game, period. But especially on the easy route and this place, I will basically just demonstrate how easy bombs can make the game here. So, yeah.
Things are starting to heat up!
Shut up, Slippy.
Quit dinking around, Flip!
As I got older, I went back and I played this game again. And I always thought Peppy... Like, when I got older, I realized he said dinking, but when how do I put this? Okay, when I got older and I went back and I played this game, I always thought he said dicking.
Don't mess up that
I don't know, maybe it was just in my mind that I thought he said that, but I went back and I replayed it, and I realized he wasn't saying dicking, he was saying dinking, but to me, he's always saying dicking. Oh, well, you know what that means, right?
Be careful, it's a trap!
It's a trap!
Of course it is. It's always a trap. In fact, this game is full of traps. Why? Because you're a Star Fox. You're a Star Fox. The whole galaxy wants you to be a Star Fox. Star Fox! Star Fox. Anyway, so yeah. Enemies like these, though, they're pretty easy to shoot down. You don't need to use bombs on them, but specifically like the butterfly enemies, you want to use bombs on them just because they're so... It's such a pain in the ass to kill. And as you can see, I failed doing so much more, but it's okay because I recover here! That's right. Screw you, game. Screw you. I don't need no stinking somersault to get the important items. Anyway. So, yeah, as you can see, it eventually becomes a big asteroid field, and just gotta be careful not to get hit by them.
Can you make it?
Of course I can.
Use the brake!
No, screw you. Boost. Boost your whole stage. Remember, it's what I said in the last level. See, now you're agreeing with me, Peppy. Now you know what I'm talking about. Dumb rabbit.
Incoming message from Rob 64.
I can see that, thank you.
Location confirmed. Sending supplies.
So yeah, this is also the first stage where they kind of start telling you how to use your boosting functions. And it's also the one where they give you your first Rob 64 transmission. So, you know, like I said, this is in the easy route. If you're going down the harder route, they don't explain this stuff, as you already know if you watch my videos. Now, as you can see,
They're on me! I'm getting
careless! Yes, you are. Anyway.
Thanks,
you're welcome. Anyway. So, yeah, during this route, there's a lot of gray meteors, boulders, asteroids, whatever you want to call them. I don't know. I guess, the term would be debris since they're in space, I suppose. There's a lot of, gray debris, and then there's brown debris. Anyway, there's a lot of brown debris. The brown debris, you can destroy. The gray, you can't, so don't even try shooting at it. It's a waste of time. So yeah, for these guys, you can't do a lock-on to destroy them all, so just throw a bomb. I could have thrown a bomb here and gotten a good amount of these guys, but I didn't really want to waste it. Also here, I could have thrown a bomb and gotten a good amount of them, but I didn't want to hurt Falco. I like the guy. He's okay. Bring me my pizza on the weekends. Anyway, these guys, though... I will use the bombs on. I hate butterflies. Bomb the butterflies. Bomb the butterflies. Bomb them! Bomb the butterflies. Bomb them! Yeah, so I think there's one more coming up here. Yeah, no, we gotta save Slippy. Yeah, that's right, that's... See, it's just, it really, really breaks the game to use bombs. I mean, I'm telling you guys, I'm trying not to break the game too much on the easy route, but, you know, whatever. Oh! That's lovely. You know, Falco can shoot through the gray debris with a single laser, but we can't do it with a double blue laser. What is this shit? So, yeah, anyway, as you can see, these spirally... I'm gonna call them warp gates. The warp gates, you go through them, and you basically activate a warp function in this level, and it's right before the boss here, and it takes you... Well, I won't spoil it. But basically, it sends you to the first planet on the medium difficulty route. So I'll be posting another video alongside this one, basically replaying through this level, except I'll be taking the warp gate to the meeting difficulty planet, and I'll also be, well, doing that one. Now, about this boss, he's pretty simple, but there is one thing about him that I'm going to tell you guys right now. It's a little story. When I was younger, this guy's voice always made me think, and now from on, like from now on, I always thought this too, that every single boss in Easy Route is just nothing but a pompous asshole, okay? And I really mean that, because every single one, I mean, they're really easy to beat, but they sound like they're so good. See, he sounds so chauvinistic, and it's really just, ugh, I hate that. See, I mean, why underestimate us? We're Star Fox, okay? Like, really, little lasers and a spinning thing that absorbs our lasers is not going to beat us, and neither are rockets. And, you know, shooting electricity in the middle of the screen, not going to beat me either. Maybe if you shot it in the entire screen and I couldn't avoid the attack and rip my wings off, maybe I'd lose then. But I'd still put up a pretty good damn fight, little guy.
I admit defeat.
Oh yeah, I'm sure you do. You know, I can already feel it coming on.
Are you gonna listen to that monkey?
No.
It's a trap!
Obviously.
You're not as stupid as you look!
See, it's just the way he can put so much infliction on his voice. Sometimes he starts out low and then he raises it. It's like, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me here right now? Yeah, so beating this guy is pretty simple. You just gotta shoot for the shiny parts, just like every other boss. Make sure you dodge his lasers. Lasers! Anyway, so, one laser. Anyway, so yeah. You know, and you beat him.
I can't believe I lost to this scum!
Yeah.
Sorry to Jeff, but I'm in a hurry.
Ho ho! Oh, Fox is such a classy guy. You know what? You know who Fox is? Fox is a George Clooney of the animal world, okay?
All aircraft report.
Well, shit, what am I thinking? George Clooney played a fox in Fantastic Mr. Fox. Hell, that was... I love that movie. Yeah, Peppy, I know. That's because you really, 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 really old. Damn rabbit. Anyway. So, yeah, the next planet... Well, that's the end of the episode, so, you know. Anyway, I'll see you guys later. Have a good day.